Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. This episode, I need to bring up constcast. This is one of the things that I get sometimes pushback from my students on when I'm teaching, and I just thought that this was an important topic to go ahead and bring up here. Now, may as well go ahead and point out that you can also buy a copy of my book, which is going to be linked at the bottom of this episode, which covers this same information as well. Now, I'm going to show you a very simple demonstration. Now, I am declaring I as const 0. I am then using constcast to get rid of the constness of I, and then I am assigning it the value 42, and I am returning I from main. Now, if we look over here and we look at Compiler Explorer's output, we can see that 0 is being returned from main, not 42. Now, lest you think that I have something up my sleeve and I am not doing a proper const cast here for some reason, I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of the const, and we can see that the compiler is now in fact generating code that returns 42 from main. So let's go ahead and put that back on here. Now, the next thing that you're going to say is, but you have O3 turned on. And you're right, I do have O3 turned on. So let's just go ahead and take this back to O0. And now what we can observe is that the compiler sets up stack space. It copies the value 0 into this location and then takes that same location and stores it in RAX. I don't know why it's doing this level of indirection. I guess because we're going through a reference here. And then it takes that memory location and it stores the value 42 in it. And then it returns 0 from main because const values cannot be mutated. It is undefined behavior if you do that. So as we can see here in the C++ standard, any attempt to modify a const object during its lifetime results in undefined behavior. And there's some examples here in the standard, but they're terrible examples. They don't illustrate the point that I'm trying to make. That is, when you actually run them through Compiler Explorer. So here you have it. This is very clear-cut case that if we try to modify this object that was declared const, that we are getting the 0 returned and we are getting undefined behavior from our compiler here. But you say, I must use constcast because I work with nonconst C APIs. Well, to that I say, you can't trust any API that does not say that the parameters are const to not modify your code. And we can actually, you know, take a look at some of these things. So I'm going to start by just poking around in the POSIX API a little bit. And we can see here for functions like opendir and scandir, POSIX is const correct. If you need to pass it a const character string that it's not going to modify, then it expects a const character string. There's no real confusion here. So similarly, if we dig into the POSIX API to this function base name, which is meant to return the last component of a path name, we see that the car pointer path is not const. Well, why is it not const? And it turns out that if we actually dig in here, we can see that the base name function may modify the string pointed to by path. It doesn't say why, it just says that it may. So it's a function where you might think, oh, I'll just cast away constness here because there's no reason for it to modify the base name. But as we've already seen, the POSIX API is const correct. And if we look at our C libraries, such as strincompare, we can see that this is in fact also const correct. It is expecting const character pointers to things. So then the next thing that you might say is, but I actually use the Win32 API. Now, the naming conventions in the Win32 API are a little bit annoying, but we can see here that load library A, for example, takes an LP C str. So it is also const correct. And if you are using library functions from Win32 that are not taking a const pointer to a thing, then it might modify it. The first excuse that you might give me for using constcast is that you're working with libraries that are not const correct. Now, that should not be true on any operating system API. We've just covered POSIX and the C standard and Win32 examples. If this is in fact false for your operating system, whatever you're using, that it does not have const correct APIs, then you are going to have trouble, but because you don't really know if any particular function may or may not actually modify the parameters passed to it. Now, the other possibility is not the system libraries, but your own internal libraries, in which case I suggest that you strongly consider start making these things const correct. We have had const for, 40 years now or something. It's probably time for your libraries that you use internally to be const correct. Now, the next thing that you might say to me is, but I need it for the Myers pattern of implementing both const and non-const versions of functions in my types. Now, I think that that particular use case is actually quite outmoded. It's should not exist anymore. We have better options as of C++ 14. So let's just say I've got, and you know, honestly, I often have a very difficult time finding a use case that really makes sense here. So I'm just going to go with the simplest possible one. I've got some private variable, and I have to implement both versions like this. Now, in the world where you're going to say I can use constcast safely here, what you might do is from the non-const version, that is from this version right here, call the const version. And you think that you can safely do this because, well, you know that you're being called via non-const pointer to this. And you end up with something that looks kind of like this, although I'm sure there's a better way to do it. What you're basically saying is, I want to take myself and, well, a const cast here is unnecessary because I'm adding const, but let's just say I'm doing a static cast. So I'm adding const to this, calling the const version of get I, and then removing the constness from the returned value, which I can safely do in this particular case. But I would offer to you instead this version. And I'm going to go ahead and implement this in C++ 14 instead of C++ 20, which I would like to. Now, I don't know if I've ever covered Decal type auto in this show before, but the basic premise is kind of like the inverse of perfect forwarding. You're saying, return back to me the exact type returned by the function that I'm calling. Now, I'm wrapping this one in parens because I want to make sure that this value I actually becomes an expression and not just an identifier. So the expression, this thing is going to be a reference to whatever this is, and the Decal type auto is going to automatically deduce this. And we have self passed in. Now this capital self here is the type that was passed as my templated type. And this is going to be a const, non-const, volatile, const, volatile, whatever the case may be. or our value reference or whatever, you could go as deep as you wanted to with this. And I could have made it not a pointer, but a reference, and anyhow. So I'm passing in this, deducing the type here, deducing the return type here, and perfectly deducing the return type here. So this is in some ways slightly more complicated, but in other ways it avoids the const cast, gives us a nice super clean place to put our common shared implementation and our presumably much more complicated than this example. And then let's just verify that this does in fact work like we want it to. Yeah, okay, this does compile, just wanted to make sense. We're still at 0 from our examples earlier, but yeah, we don't really expect anything to be happening here. This is all just gonna go away. So that is one way to avoid const cast. If you, for some reason, need to call in to a function that you don't know or trust, and it's like, it's some function that takes a character pointer and they say they promise not to modify your values. I really truly think the only safe way to actually call a function like this, I think this is necessary for safety and correctness. If you, from your perspective, this data is all logically const, but you don't have any way of trusting the function that you're calling, you might have to do something like, so dot data was added at some point for both string and vector. So we can say, give me the underlying data here. So added for both string and vector here, and we might have to make a throwaway copy. And you might end up in the situation where you say, I have to make a throwaway copy because I can't trust the other function that I'm calling to not modify my data. We have no idea where this is coming from. I mean, you know, just consider, and this is the kind of thing that sometimes people will do. You know, you want to try to call the function like this, and you can actually disable warnings and stuff that allow this, but ISO C++ forbids converting a string to a character pointer. This is write strings. Every compiler has some way of disabling this because of old code, like really old code, like 35, 40 year old code. I would strongly recommend not doing this, because if it does try to modify this data, then you could end up in a really bad place. So yeah, that's basically, there's never a reason to use const cast, or very little reason. And I will show the one place where I think maybe it sometimes makes sense to use const cast, but I'm going to caveat this with a lot of caveats. Okay, let's take a quick look at this code. This is going to be like a correct by construction kind of idea. Now, if I've got a pointer to some integer here, and I want to create this int pointer holder, and I'm creating it via a pointer to this integer. Now I'm going to call this function, this constructor here that has a non-const pointer to int, and I am going to properly set my local value saying that this thing was not const. Then if someone tries to call get mutable data, I expect the compiler to actually be able to see through all of this. So I'm returning 15 for main here because I called the version that has a non-const pointer in the constructor. I properly keep track of this. Now, if I were to make this thing const and construct it with a const pointer, then yeah, compiler goes kablooey. If in some very rare cases you can know whether or not the data was constructed as const or know if it was constructed as mutable, and you need this like super efficient storage kind of thing, then you have to make sure you get it right. The easier thing to do to get right is to actually have two different storages here. This doesn't require any kind of runtime check necessarily, although the caller of the code would have to check this. And it makes it a little bit easier to make sure that you keep everything, you know, actually correct in the tracking of the code. So even here in this case where I would say, okay, you can use constcast when you know for a fact that the data was not constructed as const, then it might be okay. So that's what I have to say. If you use constcast in cases where you know and can prove that the object was not created as const, then you are okay. This should also be strongly avoided because it is very hard to get right. So stop using constcast. Do the correct thing in your code, and if it's because of internal libraries, fix those internal libraries. And thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly, and be sure to subscribe.